Hi, once again, we're back raising questions. This time it's going to be really fast with absolutely no answers whatsoever, not even any suggestions. This is more or less a promo for the show, you might say. And I'll explain the costume, I'll explain what I can, but we're basically going to be asking questions about inequality in America. I just came across some shocking figures about earnings in America, and then we're going to go to journalism and inequality too. And there is a link between those two things. In the first place, let's take a look at earnings and see what that suggests for questions. The share of the national pie that is earned by the 1% on top and then the 50% at the bottom, those shares are radically different. I've just come across some figures for that. The top 1% in America earn 20% of all U.S. income. Let's stress that again. The top 1% of the people own or earn, rather, 20% of the national income pie. The bottom half of earners only get 12%. So that's 20% for the top 1%, only 12% for the bottom one half. That's pretty amazing. And as far as earnings are concerned, the top 10%, get this, the top 10% earn 81 times as much as somebody in the bottom 50%. The top 1%, in other words, work, let's say, one day, and somebody in the bottom 50% has to work 81 days to make those two salaries equal. That's incredible. So if you know somebody in the top 1% and you're in the bottom half, you're slaving away for 3 months while somebody else in the top 1% earns what you earn in those 3 months in one day. Pretty astounding. In absolute numbers, by the way, the top 1% each earn about $1.3 million, and the bottom 50% earn, on the average, $25,000. All of this, by the way, is from recent figures from CNN. We're plugged into all sorts of information here. What in the world is this cap for? Well, it indicates that $25,000. We just got to say that on the average, the bottom 50% earn an average of $25,000, where somebody else is earning $1.3 million in the same country, just at opposite ends of the spectrum. Why do we have to concentrate on that $25,000? Well, you take Alex Rodriguez, former third baseman for the New York Yankees, just as an illustration of the radical inequality of income in this country. Alex Rodriguez made about $20 million per year. He played about 200 games a year, and that means that he got about $100,000 per game. Every time he came up, home run, single, double, or a strikeout, the man earned $25,000, which is what the typical person earner and in the bottom half of the country's earners gets per year. All he has to do is swing the bat 4 or 5 times, aiming at a home run or an out, and he earns what somebody in the bottom half of the country gets in a year. Something's really wrong. I don't know exactly what it is. I don't know what the results of that are, but it seems to be a feature that shows that something's wrong with the country somewhere. Well, what about another form of inequality? This is really, really current. The press is jumping all over the president for vulgarity and for tweeting and sending out other sorts of messages that are pretty vulgar. There's no question about that. Nobody can really defend that. My question is, we're raising the question, where was the press? Where were all the heroic journalists that are now lecturing us about morality when a previous president, whose name I will not repeat except to say it was George W., and his gang of Cheney, Rumsfeld, and Rice, you remember these characters, all four of them did things that the current president has pretty well shied away from. At least the current president hasn't started a war, a gigantic war, killing and maiming people left and right in the scale that George W. Bush and his gang did. Again, can't excuse the current president for anything, but where were our heroic journalists when that gang of four were lying to us and committing a real obscenity, a real vulgarity, an unnecessary war in the Middle East that continues to go on and on and on with many deaths of many innocent people. That's an inequality too. And again, I want to raise that question. Where were those heroic journalists? Let's stay tuned, and we'll see what happens on the next edition or so of Raising Questions.